Go on
Marking.
In.
Marking.
Go on in and then mark.
Well, you can't do that now. You should have marked in, then go on in.
No, she told us she's going straight across.
Okay. I got camera. But if you guys need help with transition,
I can do this for sure, but I was doing the camera and then looking at the. You don't have to. You can watch the band.
Yeah, these guys probably not mess up, but I'm really mad. I'll kick all of them in the face.
Your volleyball team defeated Brighton High School last night. And your varsity boys cross country team won the first annual 10K relay.
No one cares.
Hey, there were four people clapping. I heard that.
What's wrong with that kid? And here comes Millington with their one season bow and one pace for throw.
Oh, Bob.
I know, right?
We got Millington.
What are we doing? Why are we
came out in 2011 because they had 12. And when we came there, they were like, we got 2012 and then we're so we're like,
that doesn't happen. All right. I'm right down there. With Vincent, when she closes the gate, she's going to talk for a second, I guess.
Over here. I'm over here. Okay.
Just Vincent's talking. I'm gonna be right down there. Grab my back.
Nose up, man.
Oh, that's not mine. Be right down there. Miss Vincent can come in and check on you guys after you go to the gate. Halftime show, you guys can do right there.
So we're going to
we got an intro to play, and then they're going to do like a commentary thing during halftime, and then outro. But try to film the band. So try to do that after the band.
They won't let us film.
Oh, they won't.
No.
Okay.
I don't know where. Clint. kick the hurdle on first and 10 from their own 37. Harden will start out of the shotgun position. He'll hand to Exum up the middle. Exum in the secondary and trying to draw down. That was Mayan Threkwood on the tackle. Tommy, we were talking about Munford needing to get that established. The run game here early and looked pretty good on first down.
Yes, they did. Seems to be. They're going to get a measure here, Brandon.
If you go back to last week, toward the end of the game, Munford had a few costly turnovers that ended up, you know, blowing the game for him. They had the lead of 16 with 4 minutes up in the game and a couple of turnovers. And then Hardin County was right back in. They ended up tying it up and went into overtime. And Hardin County picked off Hunter Hardin's pass and then scored on their first possession in overtime, which gave Hardin County the win.
Yeah, like you said, Demarius Exum had a costly fumble. Nick Harper had a costly fumble. And it just allowed Hardin County to get right back in the game and tie it up and eventually win in overtime.
Munford's really dinged up quiet here, aren't they, Tommy? A lot of injuries on the Munford team.
Yeah, Exum had a little bit of an ankle injury last week.
Yeah,
injury.
I don't think he's 100% yet.
Now, talking to Coach Saunders this week practice, he said Exum's only about 85-90% in this game.
He did get the start tonight, and he's had a couple of good carries. So now it's second down and 9 for Munford. Harden will roll out to his right, and he finds a man, and that's intended for Andre Bell, the tight end.
A little bit behind him there.
So that'll bring up third down and 9 for Munford. Wesley comes across with a fake to pitch to Exum. Rolls out. He's got a man. It's Antonio Moore. Moore in the open field. Moore down the sideline. And Antonio Moore will score. Touchdown, Munford. So they fake the toss. Sorry, Tommy. They fake the toss. And Harden will roll out and find Antonio Moore. Broke the tackle and took it to the house to 6. Harden showed great points on that one. Noticing the pressure getting the ball quickly to score.
Moore picked up a great block by Andre Bell on the sideline. Which allowed him to score a touchdown there. Early lead for Munford.
So that'll send out Tyler Gray for the extra point. And he puts it right through. So Munford takes the first hit here in the first quarter. They're up 7-0 with 10:43 left. Pretty good first drive, wouldn't you say, Tom?
Very, very good looking drive. Ran the ball pretty good. Had that big play right there.
Just 4 plays.
4 plays on 63 yards. That last drive. Gray has 8 touchbacks on the year already. Looking for his 9th here.
So he'll kick to Garcia and Oliver. Gray approaches the football. It's a knuckleball. It's more low. Oliver picks it up at the 5-yard line. Cuts back up across field. Makes a move. He's still on his feet. And brought down by a host of Cougars. So Tommy, Nick Hunt will take the field as Millington's quarterback. Nick Hunt is actually a transfer from Munford. He played at Munford last year. transfer over to Millington.
Good looking quarterback, the senior this year.
Millington runs the spread, and that's what they'll start out in. Four receivers down to the left. One up to the right. Hunt gets the snap, and he'll throw a screen pass to Oliver. Oliver's got some room to run. Tries to make a move, and ball's on the ground. I'm going to say he was out of bounds. I'm not sure. Yeah, they're going to say he was down. So that'll bring up a second and short for Munford. Warming back there. Great penetration right there by the senior Nate Fries, transferred from Illinois. Munford did a great job last week in getting turnovers, making Hardin County's offense turn the ball over four times with three picks, one for a pick six. That was Antonio Weber they got for carry. Draw down, and that'll bring up third and three now. This time will fake the handoff. He's being pressured. Grovey has got a man as the first down and still on his feet. Dragging the carry and finally brought down by Marquise James inside the 15 and flags are down.
Big block there from Curry Demarius on the play.
That'll be a flag on the defense for a horse collar right there. So that'll add on some extra yards to the long run. That'll be half the distance that I go.
Pretty good play call right there by Millington. Coming with a misdirection pass right there.
On third down too.
Yeah, caught the Cougars off guard right there.
So Garcia comes in motion. Hunt gets the snap and he'll take off running. And not much doing for Nick Hunt. Looks like he was brought down by Cedric Pryor.
Good to see Pryor back in the lineup tonight after missing last week with a separated shoulder. Suffered 2 weeks ago at the Dyer County game. Very vital part of that Munford defense right there. Oh, checking with Covington last week.
Hunt will hand off to Weber and he's locked down immediately. Nate Fries back there again, Tyler. Nate Fries is off to a very good game.
Hi, Mom. One down, TV.
So that brings up third down and goal for Millington. Has it back. But now that brings their fourth down.
Very good defensive stand right there for the Munford defense.
It's a bad snap, Tommy. You hate to see that after a great drive that you've had.
It seemed to be a pretty good snap, actually. It just looks like the quarterback didn't really handle it. I don't know if he wasn't expecting it or was snapped too hard or what.
So that'll bring in the lefty, Brandon Van Emmelen. They get it down and he kicks it. And that's going to be wide right. He didn't get it. So productive defense stand by Munford. Now they got the ball back up by 7. 7:24 left in the first quarter. good crowd on hand here tonight, Tommy.
Yeah, packed house. Millington fan, a lot of Millington fans showed up too, and opposing fans.
Of course, that's what you expect on the M&M Bowl. It's like this every year. So Harden to operate out of the shotgun. And he'll hand to Exum to the left. Exum runs straight up the middle. And brought down. So it's two times in a row now that Exum has had a pretty good run on first down. And that's probably what Munford's going to have to do all night, Tommy, in order to keep a lead here over Millington.
Yeah, and when you get such a big run right there on first down, it sets up your second and short, which is a lot easier and manageable than, like, let's say, a second and 10 or a second and 9.
So we'll go to Exum again. Exum cuts it back to the left, spinning off backwards. Still on his feet. Well, and he's finally brought down to the 40-yard line. I can't tell you who made the tackle because there was probably the whole team on him.
First down and 10 until the Cougars at the 40-yard line. Another JP's wing. First down.
So two straight runs to Exum now. And the first down. Tommy, would you say this is what this Munford offense has been missing out this year, is the big play on first down?
Yes and no. They haven't really gotten that first down production like they would have wanted. They've also turned the ball over a lot this year. This cost them towards the end of games, especially like last week with Hardin County.
Well, I guess we spoke too soon here with the Exum, and he slips up. So Nick Harper is in the backfield now. And he'll fake the handoff. Harden rolls out. He's got a man, and that's deflected. Looks like Jonathan Patterson got over there to make some good defensive play, and now that'll bring up third down. So third down and 10. And it looks like Millington jumped off sides. And that's what you're going to get. So they're just that much closer now to a first down. Now what do you do, Tommy? Third and 5. You've got a manageable situation here. The running back, the Maris Exum, has had a pretty good start off to the game. Would you give it to him right here?
I would give it to Exum, but if Harden feels comfortable throwing the ball, I might do a play-action pass to Andre Bale in the flat man, perhaps, or maybe a toss outside. I don't know. Munford can do a lot here.
So we'll try to get Millington to jump off again. Not working this time. So we'll check the play. Harden drops back, throws. He's got a man, Derek Pierce. And that's a Cougar first down.
Good time there between Martin and Pierce. Yeah, Pierce
called a good touchdown. Another
18
first down.
Can't defend that one that well.
So Tommy, let's talk about Derek Pierce last week against Martin County. He had a big game.
Had a very big game, Brent. Stepped up with a senior from Munford. Had two big picks. 5 tackles, 1 for a loss, and a touchdown. Caught a big touchdown pass in the fourth quarter. Munford by 16. Probably his best game of the year so far, I'd say.
They're gonna check the clock. I'm not sure what's happening here, Tommy. Do you have any idea what's going on the field?
I'm not exactly sure. There might be something wrong with the time clock or something.
I'm not sure if they're looking up at the scoreboard or if there was lightning off back in the distance.
It's lightning if you are wondering what's going on.
So we just got word that it's lightning. There's a storm approaching now.
I'm up here where I came in.
It can rain as much as it wants to, but when the lightning strikes, I'm going to postpone it for a little bit. I'm not sure what they're going to do here.
over soon. We can get back on with the game.
Yeah, you really would hate to see. Yeah. Especially in a big game like this. Everybody's ready to see the outcome of this one. So, ladies and gentlemen, if we are postponed due to weather, we will shut down, but please stay tuned for further information on getting the game back started. I'm not sure how close the storm is, Tommy. I don't know why they would wait this one out about a good 15 more minutes.
Yeah, well, whenever they see lightning, they're going to go with player safety first, as they should, really. Right. Don't want to really take a chance with somebody's life.
If you have friends or relatives at home, they didn't make it out of the game. They can view the game online at www.network.com/Munford.
So, ladies and gentlemen, they will send the teams back up to the locker room for right now. We'll be right back.
We are about to start back here in a couple minutes after this lightning delay. Shouldn't be too much longer, so y'all just hold on tight.
We'll be right back.
tennis court?
It's in my book. Okay.
Hello, everybody. We're back here in Munford after the about an hour rain delay. Well, actually, it was a lighting delay. So, Tommy, we're picking up right at 7-0. Munford is up. They had a lead after the Antonio Moore touchdown from a pass from Hunter Harden just under 5 minutes ago in the first quarter. Munford will take the ball at 3rd and 5 from it's around the 49. But yeah, they'll put it on the 44-yard line of Millington. So check that. It's 2nd down and 8. So now we're back out and ready to take action. So, Tommy, both the teams got about an hour off from the game. So what do we expect to see now?
Well, I'm not sure exactly. Munford had some momentum going into the lightning delay. Seems to pick up right where they left off. That run by Exum right there.
And that is Exum. Gets the carry, and he's going to be just short of the first down. So pretty manageable for Munford right here. They've had a good running game all night as of right now. Which it seems like it'd be deeper than just the first quarter here. We're only 4 minutes to go in the first quarter. So now they'll say that Exum picked up the first down, so we'll send Weston the motion handoff to Exum to the right, and not much doing on the first down run.
Devontae Robinson on the tackle right there, the senior for the Millington Trojans.
So the wind has picked up. Some rain is approaching off in the distance. Right now, they'll try to get as much as they can as possible. Well, hopefully, the rain will hold off for as long as possible. Harden's pass will go incomplete. Looked like he just got on top of that one too much. Threw it right into the ground. And that can be a pretty productive play for Munford. You know, they got the speed from Marquise James out there, which had a good opening kickoff return to start the game off. I'm not sure if you saw it, Tommy, but I just saw another lightning strike.
No, I actually didn't notice. Where was it at?
Harden throws. He's got a man. In and out of the hands of Derek Pierce. That would have been huge for Munford, and now brings up 4th down. I wouldn't be surprised if they went for it right here, Tommy.
Yeah, they're kind of in that no man's land right here, where it's too far to kick a field goal, but it's just short enough to be hesitant about a punt here.
I think that's what they'll do. So on 4th down and 8 from the 34, Harden out of the shotgun, gets the snap, fakes the handoff, rolls out to the left. Looks, he's got a man downfield. And in and out of the hands, again, of Derek Pierce. Not something you see from Derek Pierce. Pierce had a big game last week, pretty much caught everything that came his way. It's like a totally different ball player tonight.
Just took his eye off the ball right there at the last second. Perfect throw by Harden there. Unfortunately, Munford can't connect on the pass right there.
And they had Lewis burnt in coverage, but I think Harden might have underthrew it just a little bit, wouldn't you say, Tommy?
Yeah, maybe just a little bit right there.
So now Nick Hunt and Millington will take over on their own 34, and they'll take a timeout.
Timeout called by the Cougars, their first call timeout. 3:19 to go in the first quarter. Take off constructed materials, 51 concrete,
So now we're back after the timeout. Hunt will come out of the shotgun on first down and 10. This is snap. Three-step drop. Looks over left. Can't find anybody, so he'll take off running to the right side. He's got the first down. Nick Hunt with a lot of green from Trucks the tackler and finally brought down the 30-yard line. So a big play for Millington on first down. And now they're in the Cougar territory.
Poor job there containing Nick Hunt there as he gains about 40 yards there on the play.
So after the Nick Hunt run, and they'll toss it out to Webb. Webb runs over the tackler and out of bounds. Broke off the initial contact of Terrell Mills. This month the defense needs to wrap up, Tommy. Last week did a pretty good job in the first half of it, then it started to slip away. The same problem with Covington the week before that. Just got to wrap up and make good tackles.
It seems to be a different defense before the lightning delay. Seems to have just lost that little bit of fire that they had earlier.
So first down and 10. Hunt gets a snap, drops back, looks, he's being pressured, stumbles, makes another move, and brought down by Turner Weston. Now go is a sack by Turner Weston. Turner Weston having a tremendous start off to the year.
That's Weston's second sack on the year. Also an interception to go along with 17 tackles for the senior linebacker.
So second down at 11. Hunt will just take off after getting the snap. And he's there and dropped. Looks like Cedric Pryor got back there and made a good hit and wrapped up. So that's what you want to look to do right now if you're a Munford defense, let me say, Tommy.
Yeah, wrap up, make their tackles. Just tackle better, you know. Try to force a turnover right here.
Munford was good at that last week, causing four turnovers in just the first half. So Hunt will drop back on third down, and he loses some of the ball. Somehow manages to get it back, and he's hit hard. By Turner Weston. So that'll bring up fourth down. He got back to the original line of scrimmage.
Weston seems to be fired up by the previous play there, Brandon. Stepping out, making a sack there.
And so now they'll send on the kicking team.
Millington failed on their first attempt earlier before the lightning delay. At the same distance, about the same spot on the field.
So that'll bring out the lefty, Brandon Van Emelen, which is 0-1 on the field tonight. Drive from 31 on his first try and was wide right. Now he'll try again from about 37. He'll mark it right at 38 yards. And now a flag. Put him back 5 yards. So that's a pretty big difference right there. So now he was looking at a 38 yard field goal. Now he's got about a 42 yard field goal time.
I know he has the leg to get in from 43. I'm seeing him keep it straight here.
From the left hash, and it's blocked! That one is blocked by Antonio Moore! Moore just came off the right side, untouched it, seemed like Tommy, and dove out and made a great play and blocked it. Now momentum swing, Munford got the ball back.
Oh, 2 on field goal attempts tonight. Whole difference, whole new ball game. If it's 7-6, when you say, Brandon, then 17-0.
No doubt. So Munford on the third drive of the night. Harden looks to his left. He's got a man. That's Pierce. And there's a hook and lateral to Nick Munford. And Harper knocked out of bounds at the 46-yard line. So a little trickeration there, Tommy.
Yeah, bringing Nick Harper around right behind Antonio Moore right there. He can jump an extra about 10 to 12 yards there.
Harden under center, sends Harper in motion, and they'll toss to the Demarius Exum to the right, which cuts back the field and is hit right at the line of scrimmage. And time will expire in the first quarter, so it remains 1-7, Millington nothing. And we'll be right back. So now we're back for the start of the second quarter. So we'll change direction of field. So Harden will start out in the I formation. And some movement on the front line. I think they're going to get Andre Bell for a false start.
Just the second penalty on the Munford team tonight. Last week they had 11 penalties against Hardin County. Previous week against Covington 2 weeks ago they had 9 penalties. So they're going to look to play a much cleaner game and commit less penalties.
So Hardin will fake the toss and he finds Derek Pierce. He's brought down around the original line of scrimmage by Lewis.
The 47-yard line.
1 yard.
Bring up third down about 9 to go.
So now I bring up second down and 9. We're going to roll out. Hunter Harden throws over the middle. He's got a man and it's deflected and incomplete. Intended for Antonio Moore. It looks to be Lewis again. Lewis playing pretty good D right now.
Very fortunate he didn't pick that ball off. I guess that's why he's playing defensive back and now wide receiver.
So George Odom will go back deep to return the punt from Tyler Gray. My advice to Odom right now is to back up a little bit more. Exactly what I said, and it's a good punt. Odom will return it from the 10-yard line. Tries to make a couple men miss, he does. And he's brought down after about a 12-yard gain to the 22. So Nick Hunt and company will set up shots from there on the 22-yard line.
Ball will be spotted at the 23-yard line. First and 10 for the Cougars.
Oh, my God.
takes into the game and mishandles the bad snap. Alan Moore, the 6'2", 180-pound senior. And time is being called. And Tommy, I think they're going to get another lightning delay. They let a couple of strikes go, but that's the multiple lightning strike we've seen here in the last 5 minutes, and we're going to call this one off.
Those of you listening right now, every time that there's a lightning strike, they are required to have a 30-minute delay. So I'm guessing they are debating whether or not.
And that's exactly what it is. So
looks like it'll be another 30 minutes right here. Yeah, I've been just notified that if this game is to be canceled, that it will resume play tomorrow night at 7 o'clock Central Time.
We'll be right back.
return to. We need you to go to the gym at this time for your own safety. If you are a student here for the game and you do not have a gym to return to, you need to return to or go to the gym at this time for your own safety, please. We need to clear out the stadium.
Isn't it live, Billy?
I mean, now it's not live, I think.
Just wondering. I can just see you trying to pick out this shit, but like, I was like, there we go.
We got like 20 cops here. We can't get the stadium clear.
Ladies and gentlemen, we need the stadium clear. If you do not have a vehicle to return to, you may go to the basketball gymnasium at the time that you need to get out of the stadium. We need everyone to go to the gym entrance. Go to the gym entrance. Do not use any entrance other than the gym entrance, and then go straight.